How about this? We did a thing. We did an episode about the New York Mafia, history of the Mafia on Netflix. It was a show like the New York Mafia.
Right, right.
I know that show was on. And there's this guy John Alight on the show. Who's right, John right. Gotti's like henchman. He's like
sure, the guy from like Richmond Hill.
From Richmond Hill, yeah. You know, Albanian guy. Yeah, this guy John Alight.
Woodhaven.
Yeah, and so we did a thing where he says in the special, he says in the show, and Giannis brought up the show. It's so funny. Where he's like, look, if I come at you, he's like, listen, I go to guys and I give them the money. If they don't give me the money, then unfortunately I got to come at them in a different way.
Yeah, he goes.
Right. We started laughing. We're like, yo, we come at you in a different way.
And that became like a catchphrase on our podcast because, yeah, you know, back then what we do, I go see a guy if he owed me money. You know, he gave me the money. If I went to see the guy and he didn't give me the money, then the next time I go see him, I come see him in a different way.
I come see him in a different way. But the problem is now is he heard the podcast.
And he's going to come be a guest in a different way.
And he wants us to go to where he is to go to the podcast. And, like, and we can't figure out if he likes us or fucking we're done.
Oh, he wants you guys to go?
Yeah, yeah. He's like, I'm doing a podcast too. I heard you guys like to make fun of some of my sayings. So now we're like, fuck. Can we bring you along just in case there's trouble? You can fucking talk him down. You can bring the hawk.
I saw the. It's funny because I saw Sammy the Bull. You know.
Sure.
And I was doing Rogan, so talking about Sammy the Bull coming on, and then you know we just talked about Sammy the Bull and Michael Franchese and all these guys, and then he's like, well, he's watching. It's a podcast of him watching that conversation, and he goes, at some point, he goes, yeah, that'd be good. Yeah, see if we could be on the Joe Rogan podcast. See if we can get on there. He says to whoever he's talking to off camera. And then you see him suddenly, he goes, what am I doing? He goes, in fact, see if he can come on our podcast.
It's funny that mob guys got podcasts
they
now.
They got podcasts like yeah. that, yeah.
It's funny that everyone's asking us about podcasts.
Yeah.
We went over yesterday to set up a podcast for Chaz Palminteri. He's starting a podcast.
Yeah, oh,
Chaz
is, yeah.
It's going to be good. It's, yeah, it's going to be a good podcast, but we're setting him up. And I guess Binky Mike's going to be the producer.
Yeah, because you just keep fucking up loaning him out.
You keep loaning Mike out.
But you got to lie and tell him how much, you know what I mean? You can't tell him what you honestly get paid here. You want
to? Well, the good thing about Chaz is whatever we pay, Chaz will give you in all cash. We'll never have to claim any of it.
Yeah.
You'll just be off the books.
Same with John Elite. He wants all cash.
Yeah, all cash. Yeah, John
Elite. Italian kids love fucking lettuce.
Yeah. Oh,
they
yeah.
They love pulling it out. Lettuce. They love holding it. They love handing it over.
Yes.
They fucking love it. You know, it's funny. My granddad, one of his diners was in Red Hook down at the docks. And Albert Anastasia's brother used to control those docks.
Yes.
So my dad used to work at the diner. And he said, it was interesting the way people judge. It made me think about the way people judge history, especially the way kids are doing it now. They go back and they judge morally. My dad was coming at it from the perspective that, look, back then, things didn't come quick. Cops didn't come quick.
Right.
You know, it was like, it wasn't seen as like extortion, even right. though that's what it was.
That's right.
It played a function.
Like, that's right.
It was protection. Nobody fucked with your diner.
That's right.
Because they knew it was Albert Anastasia's.
Yeah.
And I'm sure just like the market sometimes provides, the mob knew how to push, but not too far. So they
right.
charged you enough so they wanted you to be able to afford it and whatever.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
they did provide a service. I'm not trying to defend the mob.
No, no.
Even though in your book, I think I am. You go like, the even mob, though I just did defend.
We were safe for fucking city.
At one point you were talking about incest in the Appalachians.
Oh, Kentucky, yes.
And he goes, I'm not trying to defend incest, although I just yeah. did.
Yes.
I'll tell you yeah. what, de Blasio... De Blasio would not be able to be getting away with what he's getting away with and destroying this city if the mob was still here.
Yeah.
I'll say it.
I'm just saying there's some
edit
pros.
That part out, Mike. I'm just kidding.
It's not like they didn't serve some function, you
it
know?
Didn't get a laugh.
No,
so
you're
edit
right.
It out.
No, I know what you're saying. Well, they always say that corruption always had it. The one thing about corrupt in the old days, when corruption was there, you could get things done. So now everything's above board. Everything has to be transparent, but nothing moves.
Right.
So that's why nothing ever happens.
Right.
You know,
right.
Nothing
it's true. It's, I mean, it's right. a good point.
I was in Mexico a few years ago, and I was going from the airport, and I go to the cabbie. I go, do the cops make the cops stop you, and they make you pay money? And he goes, no, you can't. He goes, they won't take money anymore. I don't know what I'm supposed to. Like he was saying, I can't do what I need to do
because
you can't pay off the cops.
Yeah.
So, I mean... There's two sides to it.
Like he was upset about it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's true, though, man. It's true. I mean, greasing somebody used to be, that's what you got into any nightclub, anything like that. Now it's like, it's a fucking federal crime. You can't do that.
Yeah.
What can you do?
We really hope you enjoyed that episode, whatever it was about. This is just a stock thing that we're taping onto every episode. So, go make sure you rate, review us, subscribe, turn on your notifications, get jiggy with it.
And go to patreon.com/Bay Ridge Boys where things get really wild.